In ichthyosis vulgaris, patients experience not just itching, discomfort and dryness, but severe versions of these symptoms. In this condition, the skin becomes not just thickened, but cracked, leading to severe pain and an increased risk of infections. Hello everyone, I am Dr. Megha Chaturvedi, and today in this video, we are diving into a topic that affects many people worldwide, which is ichthyosis vulgaris. In this video, we will discuss the difficulties faced by patients and how to manage and potentially cure this condition through Ayurveda and natural remedies, and I'll also share some unique advice for managing it at home. So let us get started. First, we will understand why ichthyosis vulgaris basically happened or how it happened. Ichthyosis vulgaris is primarily caused by mutations in the FLG gene, which encodes phlegrin, a protein essential for skin barrier functions. This genetic mutation leads to a deficiency in phlegrin, resulting in dry, scaly skin due to impaired skin barrier and reduced natural moisturizing factors. Also, environmental factors such as cold weather can exacerbate symptoms. Effective management includes regular moisturizing and, in some cases, prescription treatment are also needed. Patients with this condition often notice that their skin is excessively dry, cracking and bleeding, making everyday chores very difficult. And this can be the most prominent on the legs, arms and back. But if not treated on time, it can appear anywhere on the body. Ichthyosis vulgaris is often called fish scale disease, and it can be challenging to live with. However, with the right treatment and management, it can also be controlled and treated. So what can be done to control and treat it? Let us talk about Ayurvedic and natural tactics. According to Ayurveda, ichthyosis vulgaris is related to an imbalance in the body's doshas, primarily Vata and Kapha. When these doshas of your body are imbalanced, then our body can get abnormally, leading to numerous skin-related problems, including ichthyosis vulgaris. Now, to control it at home, I am sharing some tips with you, and by applying these tips to your affected areas, you can surely get relief within a few days. So number one, you can apply herbal oils like coconut oil, almond oil and sesame oil, which can moisturize the skin deeply, and make sure to use these oils after the bath for the best results. Number two, you can apply aloe vera gel to the affected areas of your body to soothe and hydrate your skin well. As aloe vera gel anti-inflammatory properties help reduce itching and irritation associated with ichthyosis vulgaris. Number three, you can apply a paste of turmeric powder or drink it by mixing it in water on an empty stomach in the morning to heal it from inside your body. You can also make a paste of turmeric and then apply it to the affected areas of your body. Number four, make a paste from neem leaves and apply it to the affected areas. Neem has antibacterial and antifungal properties that can help reduce skin infections and soothe irritation. Remember that managing ichthyosis vulgaris at home involves some unique approaches too. Here are few unique approaches you can opt for. Number one, use humidifier. A humidifier at home can add moisture to the air, preventing your skin from drying out. Number two, use gentle cleansers. You should avoid harsh soaps and opt for mild fragrance-free cleansers. Number three, use regular exfoliation, as gently exfoliating your skin helps to remove dead skin cells, but make sure that do not overdo it, as doing it excessively and many times, it can harsh your skin and also lead to some problems related to the skin, so be careful with exfoliation. Number four, moisturize frequently. Apply a good natural quality moisturizer. I recommend C. Ayurveda Surya body lotion, specially after bathing. This lotion helps to soften your skin and protect it from dryness and flakiness. Now, many people think we choose Ayurvedic treatment. So I want to share why Ayurvedic treatment is so essential for your condition. As Ayurveda focuses on balancing the body's natural energies and addressing the root cause of the imbalance, this holistic approach not only treats the symptom, but also helps prevent future flare-ups. And I know, living with ichthyosis vulgaris can be tough, but with the right treatment and proper care, you can lead a comfortable life. Also remember, incorporating Ayurvedic practices and natural remedies into your routine can make a significant difference. So that is all for today's video. I hope you have found this video helpful. And if you have any queries or need further guidance, please share them in the comment section or contact us via the contact number provided in the video. Let us devise the best treatment plan for your specific needs. See you in the next video. Until then, stay healthy and stay happy.